Hey everybody, John Nelson with Haas Automation here today to talk to you about M codes M10 through M13. A couple of ways these M codes may be slowing down your cycle times and what you can do to speed up your programs. M10 through M13 are rotary axis brake commands. The engage fourth axis brake command is M10. M10 applies the brake to the optional fourth axis, and M11 releases the brake. The optional fourth axis brake is normally engaged, so the M10 command is only required when an M11 has released the brake. The exact same circumstances apply to the engage fifth axis brake command, M12. M13 releases the fifth axis brake. Now, every rotary axis with a physical brake has a brake delay parameter to allow time for the brake to engage or release before program execution continues. The brake delay time is specific for each rotary axis, but averages about 1.5 seconds. There are two very important points to remember about M code brake commands. First, they're not necessary when positioning a rotary axis. Simply commanding the rotary axis to move will release the brake, position the axis, and engage the brake. It's that simple. You do not need to program an M11, then an A90, and an M10 to reclamp the brake. The other point is that once you release a rotary axis brake with an M code, it will remain released until hell freezes over, you engage the brake with the appropriate M code, or you cycle power on the machine, whichever comes first. The time when you do need to release and engage the rotary axis brakes with M codes is when you're performing simultaneous 4 or 5 axis toolpaths. You want to release the brakes because not every line of code in a full 4th or 5th axis operation contains an axis command for one or both of the rotary axes. If you do not release the brakes with the M code, your program execution will stop to engage the brake for any block of code that does not contain a motion command for that axis. So, always release the brakes with M codes before simultaneous 4 or 5 axis toolpaths, and always engage the brakes with M codes afterward. And remember, if you stop the program after the brakes are released, but before they're re-engaged, you'll need to re-engage them with M codes in MDI mode. I know what you're thinking, blah, 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 where's the cycle time savings? Okay, rotary axis brakes unnecessarily slow cycle time when you're positioning 2 rotary axes in separate lines of code or if M codes are used. Here are examples of how the time differs. This first example has 6 seconds of rotary brake delays. The M11 is going to release the 4th axis brake, and that's going to take 1.5 seconds. The M13 is going to release the 5th axis brake for another 1.5 seconds. We're going to position our B axis and C axis at the same time because they're on the same block. The M10 will clamp the 4th axis brake, and then the M12 will clamp the 5th axis brake. That's another 1.5 seconds apiece. The second example also has 6 seconds of brake delays because the rotary axes are programmed to move on separate lines of code. So the program sees B90, it's going to release the 4th axis brake and position that B90 and then engage the 4th axis brake. Then it sees the C-90 command, so it's going to release the brake for the C axis, position it to -90 degrees, and then clamp that C axis again. For maximum time savings, always position both rotary axes in the same line of code and don't use M codes for the brakes unless necessary. In the final example, both the fourth and the fifth axis brakes release at the same time and engage at the same time. So we see the command B90, C-90. We have 1.5 seconds and the fourth axis and fifth axis brakes release at the same time. We position both axes and then both axis brakes clamp at the same time. Removing the axis brake commands and consolidating the rotary axis position moves to the same line of code can reduce indexing delays from 6 seconds to 3 seconds each time both rotary axes are positioned. This can add up to a huge time savings on programs that perform a lot of work at compound angles. Pay attention to how you or your post-processor format M codes for multi-axis position moves and start reducing cycle times today. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.